Hey, creative writing class. I can't be there today because I have a doctor's appointment, and so I am making you a video instead so that we don't get behind. You should consider yourselves lucky because you get to see weekend me, who is exactly the same as weekday me, except with a cup of tea and staying in this hotel room somewhere in New Jersey. Anyway, I hope your day is going well. I made you a video on theme, which is what you're about to watch. If you're in my fifth block and you always have to take notes on the videos, you don't have to take notes on this one. So don't worry about that. It's just for your information. You today are going to need all of the work that you've done on your character stories. So you need your PowerPoint or your Microsoft Word document. And if you want the PowerPoint that's in this video, it is also on the server under theme. Anyway, have fun. Good luck writing. I will be back tomorrow and we'll talk about our story some more. See you later. So we're going to add theme to our story today. So the first thing we need to know is what is a theme and why does it matter? The theme is the message or point that an author is making about some aspect of life throughout a story. So it has to do with not only the character's life in the story, but also life that every real person lives. It's some message or lesson or point that we can make, a generalization about all kinds of life. This is what the reader is going to take away from your story. And someday, after they've read your story and they've forgotten all the details, they should still be able to say, well, that story was about finding your inner courage, or that story was about true love conquering all. So you have to find the theme for your story. So far, you have a character. You have what they desire. You have all of the things that you've put in their way, so the plot of your story. You know how it's going to end, but in order to really do a good job writing it, you need to find what the theme is, what the lesson is that your main character is going to learn. So think about your plot for a second. Think about your character at the beginning of the story and the end of the story. What is it that they have learned throughout the story? If you can come up with something that they've learned and it can apply to real people, then that is the theme of your story. Here is a huge list of ideas, and you can go online and find a bunch more. You probably have read a lot of books, and you can identify the themes from those and use some of those. You're allowed to repeat and steal themes, so you can take them from a story that you really love, or you can take it from a real-life lesson that you've learned or a movie that you've watched. You have this PowerPoint on the server, so if you want to continue to look at the theme ideas, you can pull that up. Some of them on here that I think are really good that we might use is growing up is hard, keeping secrets is harmful, not all heroes are easily identified, simple things are sometimes the most beautiful, and doing things because that's how they've always been done is not the right answer. Here's your activity. What you're going to do now is think about your character, think about what it is that you're going to have them learn, what message you want to leave your audience with, and go back through your plot. After you've identified your theme, after you've come up with the lesson that they're going to learn, go back through your plot and make sure that everything in your story is going to help us learn that lesson. So if your lesson is money is the root of all evil, then all of the struggles that your character faces need to have to do with money and it corrupting your character or it giving your character a hard time or somebody learning a lesson about how they become a worse person or how bad things happen because of money. All right, I'm going to take you through mine really quickly just to give you an example, and then it is your turn to work. Okay, so here is Adelaide, and she's the main character in my story. If you remember, she is going to discover that the boy in her class that she has a crush on has gone missing, and she needs to go and find him. So, I have Adelaide, and I have some of her classmates, and this guy right over here all the way to the left is the kid that she has a crush on, and I don't know his name yet, maybe Brian. But he's gone missing, and so Adelaide's desire, her one thing that she wants to do in this short story, is to find out what has happened to Brian. And of course, there are a lot of things that get in her way. She has to lie to her mom. She gets caught skipping class. She's scared. She's shy. She doesn't know where he is. There's somebody named Jeffrey. Let's see. Maybe a dude over here on the right is Jeffrey, and he has something to do with this missing child. So, in the end of the story, she is going to find out what happened to Brian. And of course, we discussed my really cheesy ending where everybody is happy and he falls in love with her because she saved him, blah, blah, blah. But what is it that she learns? What is the point of my story? Well, my theme is going to be you have to find enough courage to do the right thing. So even if you're like Adelaide and you're shy and you're scared and you don't have a lot of faith in yourself, you still have to find the courage inside of yourself to do the right thing, and you can. When it really comes down to it, you'll find enough courage. And that's that. You can go ahead and get started writing. Also, wanted to tell you, since it's such a short week, let's not do journals unless you really want to this week, and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye, guys.